How's everybody doing tonight? Who's excited for the Aquatic Center? Is that the real reason you guys came tonight? Some people. Or is Jesus the real reason you came tonight? That's right. Get it together over here, boys. Figure out your priorities. Hey, no, we're so excited you guys are here. Guests, we are even more excited that you're here. Let's all give a hand to the guests in the house. Give them a good old Eastside Youth welcome. I saw somebody back there. She was like, yeah, I'm a guest. Yep, clap for me. That was awesome. Hey, I only got one announcement. Gratitude Gang meets on Tuesdays at 11. They meet and they pray and they go out and they have some food. Don't be late because I walked through the other day and I got death glares all the way through while they were trying to pray. It was bad. But be there at 11, correct, Chaz? Right in here in the warehouse? All right, right in here in the warehouse, Tuesdays at 11. And then Tate said it was like till 1:30 or something like that. They go and have good food. So if you like good food and you like prayer, come and join us Tuesday, 11 o'clock. All right, we're going to keep it going. We're just going to keep on worshiping tonight. So let's do it.
Say yes, Lord. I
Amen. You guys go ahead and have a seat. Underneath your all's chairs should be a cup with some juice and a cracker in it. If you don't have one, raise your hand. I'll have somebody bring that around. I love that song. Just, here I am. You can have it all. There's no better way to say it. We love Jesus enough. We can confidently say, God, my way is awful. Whatever I have, you can have it. You can have it all. All my frustrations, all my fears, all my anxieties, every tear, you can have it all. I am available for you to use me any way you want. Would you guys bow your heads and pray with me? Father, we pause this evening to give thanks, to thank you for your Son, Jesus. And through him, none of this would be even possible. Without him, nothing. None of this would be possible. Through him, all we do here is possible. And we are forever grateful. There's nothing we can do to justify it. There's nothing we can do to repay it. But the body that was broken and the blood that was shed was the ultimate sacrifice. And we are forever grateful. And so because of that, Father, we become available to you, to the King of every nation, to the King of our hearts, to the King above all other kings, the Savior of the universe. We just lift up all of our gratitude, all of our thanks, and all of our praise. We love you. We pray all these things in your Son's precious name. Amen.
Praise the Father. I'm so glad that you're here today. What a great crowd on a great summer night. As Alex said, maybe the Aquatic Center had something to do with it, but who cares? You're here, right? I'm just super pumped to see some people that I haven't seen in a little bit, so that's super exciting. And we're going to get in the Word, and I'm actually going to preach a little shorter than I usually do. Can I get an amen or hallelujah? Wow. Y'all are toxic, man. And then I just wanted to make sure if anyone else didn't know this, tonight after the Aquatic Center, if you are able to stay late, we're going to do a fireworks show, okay? And that will be around 9:30. So if you can stay late, it will probably wrap up around 10 o'clock. We're going to have some fireworks, and there's some pretty legit fireworks. Me and Silas were just walking in Sam's Club about 2 months ago and found them for like half off, and we were like, yes, we're buying those, okay? So if you're a teenager, which 90% of you in the room are, one of your things that you look forward to the most is getting your license. And some of you, you waited like way too long to get your license. I'm not looking at anybody in particular. I don't want to call anybody out or make anyone feel embarrassed, but some people wait way too long to get the, and I was looking at somebody. And then there's some people that as soon as they can, they get their license. And you like to get your car and be able to drive because now you're kind of in control, right? You get the car that you want. You get to drive how you want to drive, which I hope you all go exactly the speed limit and follow all the rules of the road. But just don't die. But one of the things that you like about getting your car is you get to pick what you listen to, the music, right? And that's just the way of life now. You don't ever drive without not listening to something, right? I remember when I got grounded when I was in high school, and it was for about like a month, and my parents took away the car that I drove and gave me a little like junk truck that had nothing cool about it, and I called it Grounded, and I named it Grounded because it was terrible to drive. And one of the worst things about the truck, honestly, was that it didn't have an aux cord. It didn't have Bluetooth. And so, you know, maybe I'd pull up to school or the stoplight, and some whack song was playing, and I would probably get judged in that moment because, like, dude, what are you listening to? But it wasn't my fault. But I want to kind of ask you this question, and I want you to go through this train of thought with me. For those of you that drive, and for the day that you do drive, what if you gave Jesus a ride? Like, what if you gave him, like, for me, I would take Jesus to the B-dubs. I'd take him to Buffalo Wild Wings. That's where me and Jesus would go. We would eat the unlimited boneless meal. He would make all of them just repeat so we didn't have to get new orders. If you know anything about the Bible, you kind of understood what I was saying with that. But we would go to Buffalo Wild Wings, and on the way there, I would probably put on some of my favorite worship songs. That's what I would listen to with Jesus, 100%. And a few months ago, I kind of polled whoever was at that service, and maybe you're like, oh, now that's why. I remember now that's why we did that. But we got our favorite worship song from everyone that was there that night. And if you were here, you texted me what your favorite worship song was. And between that and Alex, we determined what the favorites were of Eastside Youth. The anthems, the songs that if you go to Eastside Youth, this is what we are probably doing. And so we're going to take the month of July, and we're going to look at these four songs. And we're going to look at the truths behind these songs, because something that you may not know is we don't just sing them because they have the name Jesus in it or because they're catchy. No, we sing them because of the biblical truths that are behind the songs and how we worship God. And so maybe one of the most slept on worship songs in terms of its truth, in terms of the theological value that it has, is the song Glorious Day. And if you're an Eastside person, you know that song. And there's this passage in the book of Ephesians that I think really shows us the power of Glorious Day. So I want to read this for you. And I'm not going to have it on the screen. I just want you to listen to this. If you need to close your eyes, whatever you need to do so you can really just focus in on this, I'm going to read it. And just listen to these words. It's Ephesians chapter 2, verses 1 through 10. And this is the whole idea of the song in our study today. It says this: once you were dead because of your disobedience and your many sins, you used to live in sin just like the rest of the world, obeying the devil, the commander of the powers in the unseen world. He is the spirit at work in the hearts of those who refuse to obey God. All of us used to live that way, following the passion and desires and inclinations of our sinful nature. By our very nature, we were subject to God's anger, just like everybody else. But God, who is so rich in mercy, and he loved us so much, that even though we were dead because of our sins, he gave us life when he raised Christ from the dead. It is only by God's grace that you have been saved. For he raised us from the dead along with Christ and seated us with him in the heavenly realms because we are united with Christ Jesus. So God, who can point to us in all future ages as examples to the incredible wealth of his grace and kindness towards us, as shown in all he has done for us who are united with Christ Jesus. God saved you by his grace when you believed. And you can't take credit for this. It is a gift from God. Salvation is not a reward for the good things we have done, so none of us can boast about it. For we are God's masterpiece. We are created as new in Christ Jesus, so we can do the good things he planned for us a long ago. And that's the heart behind the song Glorious Day. And I want to kind of explain this because obviously that's a lot, okay? But I want to kind of narrow down the focus of that passage and of the song for you. And the way I'm kind of describing it is the days, okay? There's several days and there's different eras that you have, all right? The first kind of days that we see is described in the first three verses. And here are some of the phrases and messages of the first three verses that if you didn't catch it the first time, dead in your transgressions, disobedient, followed in the ways of the world, following the ways of the flesh, deserving a wrath. And what I want to look at these as the old days. All right, a lot of people refer to them as their before Christ days, your BC days. The days that you had before Jesus, that if you've not made a personal decision to follow Jesus, the old days. Okay, then there's this next segment of the passage. It's kind of broken up into two. And it talks about, in verses 4 through 10, a completely different tone and a completely different look of it. It says, here's some of the phrases, made alive in Christ, incomparable riches of his grace, the gift of God, the kindness of Christ Jesus. And this is describing the new days. Okay, so you go from the old to the new. And here's what it is. The before and after of accepting Jesus as your personal Savior. So you got the old when you weren't following Jesus, you haven't made a personal decision to follow him, and now you have the new days following Jesus, and you're now a Christian. And here's one of the tough things about this that I believe is a really big misconception for people when they give their life to Christ. And it's really important that we talk about this and that we're very clear about this for people who give their life to Jesus and make a first-time decision to follow them. And there's this belief, here's the misconception, that when you follow Jesus, life is just now good. Because you're in the new days, like everything is great now. You don't have to worry about anything anymore. You're good, man. And that here's the misconception. When you follow Jesus, it's still tough. Because there's someone who wants to destroy you and wants to steal the joy that you have in the new days. Here's kind of how I explain the new days to new Christian. Who here likes shoes? Okay, anyone like shoes? Okay. When you get a new pair of shoes, if you admit it, there is some swag that you have. Because they're clean looking, like they're white, especially if there's a lot of white in the shoes, they just look very clean, okay? So you kind of walk around with a new swag because of your shoes. My buddy Clayton that you might have heard a second ago in the tech booth, he walks up to me every Sunday and he says, Alex just raised him up if you look and say, aw. But Clayton always is like, I got blue shoes, I got green shoes, okay? He's like Dr. Seuss, it's cool. But Clayton's a cool dude, and we like to talk about shoes, and I love shoes, especially when they're new, because they give you this confidence that, man, these look good, and there's this confidence that you have when you follow Jesus. But here's where the confidence comes from. It doesn't necessarily come from the now. It comes from what is to come. There's this hope that we get in Jesus, and it's different than any other hope. You hear people talk about hope, and you're like, oh, I hope that this happens. And that's not what we're talking about. A hope in Jesus is knowing that there's going to be a day where you're reunited with your personal Savior. And you look forward to the moment. The gift of salvation is eternal life. It's not the new days, but it's the glory that is to come in the future. And so you're so pumped about how Jesus has saved you because of your sin. You were in need of a Savior. And now you live your life with a hope and a freedom because there's going to be a day where you're going to be united with Christ and you have a relationship with Him. And that's what we call the glory day. And so you go from the old day to the new day, and now you're in the glory day, and you're looking forward to the moment where you are united with Jesus. And if you're a Christian, you know about that. You know about the joy that we get in looking forward to. Because of what Jesus has done for me, I can live my life, I can tell other people about Him, I can live life with a joy because not only what He has done in my life, but what is to come. There's a passage of scripture in the book of Revelation that describes this really well that I wanted to read. And again, I'm just going to read it, and I want you to just listen to these words. It's talking about when we get to heaven. And it starts in verse 1 of chapter 21. It says this: "Then I saw a new heaven and a new earth, for the old heaven and the old earth had disappeared, and the sea was also gone. And I saw the holy city, the new Jerusalem, coming down from God out of heaven like a bird beautifully dressed for her husband," a bride rather. "I heard a loud shout from the throne saying, 'Look, God's home is now among his people. He will live with them and they will be his people. God himself will be with them. He will wipe away every tear from their eyes, and there will be no more death or sorrow or crying or pain. All these things are gone forever.'" Here's the hope that we have in Jesus. If you've made a decision to follow Jesus, here's the hope that we have. That there's going to be a day where there's no more pain. That there's going to be a day when there's no more tears, where there's no more sorrow, there's no more insecurities, there's no more impurity. And so we get to look forward to meeting our Savior and being with him in perfect relationship with God in eternity forever. And that's the glory day. That's what we get to look forward to. The first time I ever came to Eastside was when I was an eighth grader. And I came with the Shots, if anybody here knows the Shots. And we came for a night of worship, and there was just a lot of things that I really liked about it, but one thing that was really intimidating about Eastside was they did worship completely differently than I was used to, and that was really intimidating and really scared me. I was honestly a little spooked because we didn't have instruments or anything, and that freaked me out. But as the night of worship went on, Aquila, if you know Aquila, our worship leader, he was doing the night of worship, and there's this song that he introed, and he was talking about this joy that we have in Christ and the freedom that we have in him. And Eastside, man, they lost their minds when this song came on. Like, I was almost a little bit judgmental about it. Like, there's no way that this is genuine. Like, there's no way that they're actually this hyped right now, that this has to be for something else. But no, the room was just completely filled with this utter joy when this song came on. And maybe you're putting like the pieces together right now, but the song that they sang was Glorious Day. And this song is an anthem. And if you've done it before, you know that we go crazy during this song. And the joy that we have when we worship our Savior is we know that because he has saved us, that there's going to be a day where we're united with him. That he has corrected our wrongs, and we get to have joy about that. That we get to celebrate what he has done in our lives in the old days, how we can live differently in the new days, and the glory day that's waiting for us. So what I want you to do is I want to invite you to stand, and if you feel comfortable, that you'd come to the front as we declare with this anthem the joy that we have in this song. Let's do it.
I was buried beneath my shame. Who could carry that kind of weight? It was by two till I met you. I was breathing but not alive. my failures, I try to lie. It was my dream till I bled in. You called my name, and I ran out of that grave. Out of
when I was broken, you were my healing. Now you're love.